Hello, welcome to another module in this online course, Strategy and Introduction to Game Theory. We are looking at auctions as Bayesian games, and we have looked at the first prize auction and the second prize auction. Let us now look at a slightly different auction format, that is an all-pay auction. So let us look at an all-pay auction. Again, similar to the earlier auction scenarios, let us consider a two-player auction. Let us consider a two-player auction, player 1 and player 2. These are our two bidders, right? And let their bids be given as B1, B2. That is, B1 is the bid of player 1, B2 is the bid of player 2. So, B2 is bid of player 2 and B1 is bid of player 1. The player with the highest bid wins. The player with the highest bid wins, but both the players submit or both the players pay their bids irrespective of winning or losing. However, both That is, both the players pay their bid irrespective of the outcome. That is, the winner is paying his bid, and the loser is also paying his bid. Remember, this is very different compared to a first prize or a second prize. In a first or second prize auction, we said that only the winner, in the first prize auction, the winner pays his bid. In the second prize auction, the winner pays the second prize bid. However, in this auction, in the all pay auction, we are saying that each player, that is player 1, bids an amount B1 and player 2 bids an amount equal to B2, and the player with the highest bid wins the auction, and both players pay their respective bids, that is B1 and B2, irrespective of the outcome. So you can think of these bids as sunk costs, right? So irrespective of the outcome, irrespective of winning or losing, each player is paying his bid. Right? So, each player is paying his bid, right? And we are also going to assume, again similar to the first and second prize auction, let us assume that V1 and V2 are the valuations of players P1 and P2 respectively, which are independent and distributed uniformly in the interval 0 to 1. Let us assume that V1, V2 denote the valuations of P1, P2 respectively, and also V1, V2 are independent, and these are distributed as uniform and these are distributed as uniform random variables in the interval 0 to 1. And for this all pay auction format, we are going to show that B1 equals half V1 square and B2 equals half V2 square. We are going to show that this is the Nash equilibrium for the auction. with the valuations distributed as independent uniform random variables in the interval 0 to 1. Again, let us follow a similar procedure. Let us start by assuming that player 2 is bidding B2 equals half V2 square, and let us find the best response bid B of player 1. Let us start with the assumption player P2 is bidding B2 equals half V2 square. We will find the best response bid B of player 1. Let player P1 bid B. Now, let us denote the expected payoff of player P1 by pi of B. So, by pi of B, let us denote the expected payoff to player 1 as a function of his bid B, right. So, pi of B denotes the expected payoff to player 1 as a function of his bid P. And therefore, pi of B is equal to the probability of win, that in case he wins, multiplied by his revenue on winning. Remember, his revenue on winning is his valuation minus his bid B, right, plus probability that he loses, in case he loses, that is the probability of loss times, remember, he pays his bid irrespective of the outcome. So, in case he loses, he does not get the object, but he simply pays his bid, which is B. Therefore, his payoff is minus B, right, because if he loses, he does not get anything and ends up paying his bid B. Therefore, his net payoff is 0 minus B, which is minus B. So, the expected payoff pi of B as a function of B is probability of win times, when he wins, he gets the object. So, his net payoff is valuation V1 minus B plus probability of loss times simply minus B, right. Now, let us find what this quantity probability of win is. Remember, he wins, P1 wins, if his bid B is greater than or equal to B2 equals half V2 square, implies half V2 square is less than or equal to B, implies that he wins when V2 is less than or equal to square root of 2B. So, therefore, the probability of winning equals probability V2 less than or equal to square root of 2b, but V2 is a random variable which is uniformly distributed in 0 to 1. Therefore, probability V2 is less than or equal to square root of 2b equals probability V2 belongs to the interval 0 comma square root of 2b. And remember, the probability V2 belongs to the interval 0 comma square root of 2b is simply the rent of the interval, that is square root of 2b. Therefore, the probability of winning is equal to square root of 2b. This is equal to the probability that B wins, bid B wins the auction for player 1. And therefore, the probability of loss is 1 minus the probability of win, that is 1 minus square root of 2b. Therefore, probability of loss equals 1 minus probability of win, which is 1 minus square root of 2b. And therefore, now substituting this back in this expression for pi b, we have expected payoff pi b is probability of winning, that is square root of 2b times v1 minus b plus probability of loss 1 minus square root of 2b into minus b, which we can now expand as square root of 2b v1 minus b square root of 2b minus b plus b square root of 2b. These factors b square root of 2b cancel, and therefore what we have is square root of 2b v1 minus b. So, the probability p of pi of b equals pi of b is equal to square root of 2b v1 minus b. Remember, this is the expected payoff to player 1 as a function of bid b. So, the expected payoff pi of b to player 1 as a function of his bid b is square root of 2b times v1 minus b. Now, therefore, to maximize this, to find the best response bid b, we have to maximize this, which means we have to differentiate with this with respect to b and set it equal to 0. So, therefore, differentiating this with respect to b, we have dou pi b by dou b, which is equal to square root of 2 times v1 times the derivative of square root of b is 1 over 2 root b minus the derivative of b with respect to b equals 0. So, we have square root of 2 v1 1 over twice square root of b twice square root of b minus 1 is equal to 0, which implies that square root of b is equal to v1 divided by square root of 2, which implies that b is equal to half v1 square. B is equal to half v1 square. So, we started with the assumption that b2 equals that player 2 is bidding b2 equals half v2 square, and we have demonstrated that the best response bid b of player 1 is b1 equals half v1 square. Similarly, it can be shown, that if b1 equals half v1 square, then b2 equals half, then b equals half v2 square is a best response bid for player b2. So, therefore, b1 equals half v1 square and b2 equals half v2 square are the best responses to each other in this two player all play auction game, and therefore, we are saying that we have shown that b1 equals half v1 square, b2 equals half v2 square. This is the Nash equilibrium. Of the two player all pay. This is the Nash equilibrium of the two player all pay auction game, that is b1 equals half v1 square and b2 equals half v2 square. And we have also used the assumption that v1 and v2 are valuations which are independent random variables distributed uniformly in the interval 0 to 1. Let us now find the expected revenue of this two player auction game. The expected revenue of the two player all pay auction. Let us find the expected revenue. Now, we have seen that at Nash equilibrium, the Nash equilibrium bids are b1 equals half v1 square, b2 equals half v2 square. And remember, these bids are paid irrespective of the outcome. Therefore, the revenue to the auctioneer, equals B1 plus B2, which is equal to half V1 square plus half V2 square. Therefore, the revenue to the auctioneer is simply B1 plus B2, because irrespective of the outcomes, the bids B1 and B2 are paid to the auctioneer. Therefore, the revenue is B1 plus B2, which is equal to half V1 square plus half V2 square. And now we have to compute the expected revenue. Which is equal to half expected value of V1 square plus half expected value of V2 square, which is equal to half integral between 0 and 1 V1 square times the probability density f of V1 times V1 dV1 plus half between 0 and 1 the expected value of V2 square, which is V2 square f of V2 multiplied with the probability density of V2 times dV2. But V1 and V2 are uniform random variables distributed uniformly in the interval 0 to 1. Therefore, f of V1 and f of V2 is simply unity. Therefore, this is equal to half integral 0 to 1 V1 square dV1 plus half integral 0 to 1 V2 square dV2. Which is equal to half integral 0 to 1 V1 square dV1 plus half integral 0 to 1 V2 square dV2, which is equal to half V1 cube divided by 3 integrated between the limit 0 to 1 plus half V2 cube divided by 3 integrated between the limits 0 to 1, which is equal to half into 1 by 3 plus half into 1 by 3 equals 1 by 3. And therefore, once again we are seeing that the revenue of the all pay two player Bayesian auction is also in fact 1 by 3, and this should not come as a surprise, because we can predict this from the revenue equivalence principle. Remember, we have talked about the revenue equivalence principle, which states that irrespective of the auction format, the revenue to the auctioneer is equal. Therefore, what we have seen is the across the auction formats, although the Nash equilibrium bids are changing, what is not changing is the revenue to the auctioneer. That is, we had seen in the Bayesian first price auction, the second price auction, and now in the Bayesian all pay auction, that the revenue to the auctioneer is fixed, which is 1 by 3. Therefore, this is an illustration of the revenue equivalence. This is an illustration of the revenue equivalence principle. So basically, we have now, what we have done is we have looked at several auction formats. We have looked at the first price auction, the second price auction, and all pay auction, and we have modeled these as Bayesian auctions with uncertainty in the valuations, and we derived the Nash equilibria of these various auctions, and we also derived the expected revenue, and we have illustrated the revenue equivalence principles for these Bayesian auctions. Let us conclude this module here. Thank you very much.